Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today I am going to show you how to create a virtual machine in Windows 11 using Oracle VirtualBox, and we will install Windows XP on it. For that, first you need to enable virtualization. If you have not enabled virtualization on your PC yet, don't worry, I have made a video on that and you can find the link in the description below. So let's see how you can run older software on Windows 11. So first, we need to download and install Oracle VirtualBox. So first, open your web browser and search for Download VirtualBox. And go to the VirtualBox websites. Here, you can see the latest VirtualBox version 7.0.18 platform package. From here, download the latest version of Windows host. Okay, just click on this. It's nearly 104 MB size, so download can take few seconds depending on your internet speed. Okay. Once the download is complete, run the installer and you can follow the on-screen instruction to install VirtualBox on your computer. Once you have VirtualBox installed, the next step is to download the Windows XP ISO file. As you know, the Windows XP has been archived by Microsoft. But don't worry, I will show you how you will get Windows XP ISO file for free. Okay, so for that, you need to open one site. The link I have given in the description so that you can copy from there. And the site is archive.org. From here, you will get your Windows XP 32-bit ISO file along with the product key you can see. In the right side, under download option, you will find ISO image. Once you click on this, download begins started. It's nearly 600 MB of sizes, so it may take some time depending on your internet speed. Okay. Now that we have VirtualBox installed and the Windows XP ISO downloaded, now it's time to create the virtual machine and install Windows XP on it. So now open VirtualBox. And click on New. This will start the wizard to create a new virtual machine. First, name your virtual machine. I'm going to name it Windows XP. Now select the ISO image from your drive. And you can see type as Microsoft Windows and version Windows XP 32-bit is automatically selected. Check beside the box, skip unattended installation and click Next. Here you need to allocate the base memory size. I am going to set it 1024 MB. But you can allocate more if you have enough RAM. After that, click on Next. Now we need to create virtual hard disks. Select Create a virtual hard disk now and make the size 20 GB. You can allocate more if you want. Okay, then click on Next. Finally, you can see all the settings you have made in summary section. And after that, click on Finish. Our virtual machine setup is ready. Now it's time to install Windows XP on it. Okay. The virtual machine will boot from the ISO image. Starting the Windows XP installation process. Here you can notice setup is starting Windows. At the Windows XP Professional Setup screen, you must press Enter to begin installation Windows immediately. Now you need to press the F8 key to accept the license agreement and continue the installation. Press Enter to install Windows XP on the selected items. Here, you need to select Format the partition using the NTFS file system quick by using the arrow key on keyboard and press Enter. Setup is formatting your virtual disk. Once the virtual disk has been formatted, setup is copying files. It will take some time to copy, okay? So be patient. After copying the system files, your virtual computer will restart automatically in 5 seconds. You can press Enter to reboot your virtual system immediately. After your guest machine restarts, the installation will continue. And here, configure the region and language options of Windows XP. You can customize according to your country. Then click on Next. And here you need to type a name of your user account you will use in your virtual system. Okay, so I'm going to name it Tech Infokart. And in organization name, I'm going to write Home. And then click Next. In this page, enter a Windows XP product key. You can copy the product key from the site, or you can also find the desired product key for the same in the description below. Okay. And finally click Next. And in this page, type the computer name you want to use and create a new password for the administrator account. But I'm going to leave this field blank to avoid making a password. Okay. Then click on Next. Configure your virtual computer date, time and time zone settings according to your location. And click Next. Choose whether to use typical or custom settings. I'm going to select typical and click on Next. And here select Workgroup and click Next. Now wait while Windows XP is installed. After the Windows XP system files are copied, your system will reboot. And your desktop will be ready. You must hear the old nostalgic Windows XP sound, isn't it? Okay, so after completing and finalizing the setup process of Windows XP on VirtualBox, you will have the familiar desktop interface of it. You can also set up the desktop icon according to your need. And here, one thing you must notice that you can't make this full screen by default. For that, we have to install VirtualBox Guest Edition in Windows XP. To enable this, click on Devices, then click on Insert Guest Edition CD Image. After that, open My Computer inside Windows XP and double click on the VirtualBox Guest Edition drive. Then click on Next. Again click on Next. And finally, click on Install. This will start the installation. Once the installation is done, just reboot your system. Now click on View and then select Full Screen Mode and click on Switch on the screen that appears. Finally, you will get the fully working Windows XP with full screen on your physical Windows 11. If you want to close these virtual machines, just click on File and then click Close. Then click OK. It will close the VirtualBox. And in future, whenever you want to use the Windows XP, simply open the VirtualBox and select Windows XP. Then click on Start. It will again open the Windows XP on your current operating system. Okay, so that's it. This is how you have successfully created a virtual machine in Windows 11 using VirtualBox and installed Windows XP on it. I hope you like this video. If you found this video helpful, please give it a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe to my channel for more tech tutorials. Also, if you have any question, always leave your comments below. Thanks for watching and I will see you in the next video.